Hi everyone and welcome back. So in previous couple of videos we talked about API gateway and integration with Lambda. Now in this video we will explore more on the API gateway features. Okay, so in the last video we already did the integration of these endpoints with the Lambda. Like you can see, the GET is already integrated with some Lambda. This is a resource and this is HTTP GET method which is integrated with the Lambda, and we were also able to test this using this, and it is calling Lambda and we are getting the response. Now how to deploy this? Because it's Lambda, we are able to test it locally on the AWS console, but how we deploy it? Deploy API, and we have this stage. If you don't have any stage created, you have to create a new one like this. Like you want to create a new stage QA. These stages can be considered as an environment, and I'm deploying it. After you deploy, you will get an endpoint. Okay, so you can see I got this kind of endpoint. This is an invoke URL, right? And missing authentication token. Now we need to explore what is happening with this. So this is API gateway endpoint, and you can see all the other things. Stage variable, only one stage variable is added. Dev, if you want to create a new stage, then you can do it like this. So we have this resource, you can create a multiple stage. Currently dev is the only stage we have. Okay, so if I just try to go with users, okay, I think this is user, we are getting the response, right? This is what is expected from this API. Now, what these stage variables are, like you want to deploy to a different environment, different versions of Lambda, then you can create a multiple stages. Other than that, let's talk about authorizer. So what is authorizer? Authorizer enables you to control the access of your APIs. Right now, this API is open. Anybody can hit this API and they can get this response. They can hit this API n number of times, right? This API is not protected. So what is the use of authorizer? Authorizer enable you to control the access of your APIs with either Cognito user or either some kind of a token, right? So if you talk about this, Lambda authorizer is an API gateway feature that use Lambda function to control access of the API. If you look at this diagram, we will get to know more about this. So what this diagram is saying is we have the API gateway. We have some API, we are exposing API. Now this Lambda authorizer is nothing but a Lambda. What it will do is it will check few things, maybe authorize a token or some request object, and will say, okay, you are allowed to go further on the API gateway otherwise. So this authorizer Lambda will return the policy. The policy will say, okay, you are allowed to execute the Lambda, which are mapped to these API endpoints, okay? This policy can be cached and all these are functions, but this Lambda should return a policy. What if you just see the code, what we have to write in this Lambda? Just an example, this is a simple Node.js Lambda. If I just zoom in a little bit, okay, I have to zoom out. This is the Lambda code look like for the authorizer. What it is doing is it is checking your token. Based on token, it is returning a policy. Generate policy, allow, user allow, user deny, user unauthorized, invalid token. So what it is looking for is just a token in the headers. Now, how you validate the token, that's on you. You may call another third party service to validate this token and get the response back. If it is 200, then okay, return the allow policy, return the deny policy, something like this. Here you can create a new authorizer. So if I just create a test authorizer for Lambda, Lambda function is this. You can, and this is authorization token. If you just look at the documentation, what all you need to add. Here you just need to add authorization token. Okay, just give me a second. Create new authorizer, type Lambda. Lambda invoke role, you can leave empty. And the header value. So you can just add the header value and get that working. So there are two type of authorizers we are adding, right? One is, if I just go to authorizer back again, one is a Cognito and one is a Lambda. And in the Lambda also, you have two types, request types or token type. I mean, if you are looking for a particular header in the request, then you have to specify that header. If I already know that my header will have authorization token, so if you are choosing token, that means you will be sending authorization token in the headquarter lambda. And this is what? This is how we create an authorizer. Now, if you just go to the request, that means in header, this can be your custom. In the header, you are sending some attribute, right? In the token, it is specific, okay, you have to specify authorization token only. But in the request, you can set, okay, authorization I'm sending. And in the authorization of the, in the header, I'm sending a token, which is, can be a JWT token, which I will validate from third party service. And this Lambda will talk to the third party service like auth 0 service, which will validate the token, or Firebase. Once the token is valid, then you just return a policy. Okay, like here, this Lambda function is doing. Here we got the token from the authorization token. And if token is allowed, then we are sending it like this. So we can also do this. We can play around with this. The response, this is fine. All the stages we have done. Now coming to the other parts like API keys. Okay, so the API keys in the API gateway, like if you want to put some custom API key for your, for accessing your APIs, like either custom or auto-generated. Okay, what you want is whenever the client is accessing my API, right, they should always provide this X API key in the headers, right? So that means you are actually protecting your API by providing the X API key. So nobody now can access directly your APIs. They have to pass this API key. Then only they will be able to access your APIs, right? I will just delete this API key for now. And let's... Now, so this is all about API key, adding the custom authorizer. These are all are actually different features. We can also talk about WebSocket configurations on the API gateway, but that is, we can skip for now because that is not we are targeting. These are just the dashboards, resource policy. Okay, now in the next video, we'll talk about the IAM, Identity Access Management, for the API gateways and Lambda. Okay, that's all in this video. This is just talking about how we can deploy the API gateway endpoints, okay, how you can configure the authorizers, and how you can set the API keys.